Now we'll derive the formula of potential energy of dipole in external electric field. Suppose there is a dipole in uniform external electric field, then what happen? This electric field exert torque on this dipole. So torque acting on dipole in electric field is given by torque is equal to PE sin theta. Now to rotate the dipole from some angle theta 0 to theta 1, you have to apply the same torque in the opposite direction of this torque acting by electric field. So the external torque required to rotate dipole is same amount of torque you required in the opposite direction of this torque. So this much torque you required. This is the variable torque. Why? As you are rotating the dipole, this theta will vary. As the theta varies, this torque, external torque, will also varies. So this is the variable torque. So the work done by external torque to rotate dipole is integration of torque into angular displacement, right? Like we are using the formula force into displacement. This is the angular displacement. In place of force, there is a torque. So external torque is equal to PE sin theta d theta. This d theta indicate, you have to integrate this sin theta and you have to substitute the limit of theta. We are rotating the dipole from theta 0 to theta 1. Now PE is constant, you have to integrate only sin theta, and the integration of sin theta is minus cos theta, and you have to substitute the limit theta 0 to theta 1. So PE minus cos theta 1 minus cos theta 0 means minus minus plus cos theta 0. So this is equal to minus PE cos theta 0 cos theta 1 plus PE cos theta 0. This work gets stored as potential energy of dipole. Dipole is at angle theta 0. You are rotating the dipole at angle theta 1. For that you are doing some work. Your work gets stored in the form of potential energy of this dipole. So this work is stored as potential energy of dipole. So already dipole has some potential energy and you are doing some work, means you are adding some energy to this. So this work done is equal to the change in potential energy. So change in potential energy is equal to PE minus cos theta 1 plus cos theta 0, right? Now this change in potential energy means this is the energy at theta angle to the energy at some reference point. In measuring the potential energy, we are always considering one point where the potential energy is zero. That is called reference point. So this is the difference of potential energy at angle theta and at angle theta 0. Now we are selecting the reference point where the potential energy is zero. If we substitute this theta as a pi by 2, then cos pi by 2 becomes 0. So the potential energy at pi by 2 is equal to what? 0. So we are considering reference point. Let theta 0 is equal to what? Pi by 2. And this reference point, potential energy at a reference point is always what? 0. In 11th standard, you already studied that at 0 height you are taking the potential energy 0 and at h height you are taking the potential energy as mgh. So this potential energy is with respect to this ground. So you are measuring the potential energy with respect to this ground. and this ground is your reference. So here our reference is pi by 2 angle. At pi by 2 angle, this potential energy is what? Zero of dipole. Now u theta minus 0 is equal to PE. Take this cos theta 1 as common theta, some angle theta, and this cos theta 0 reference angle as pi by 2. So cos pi by 2 is equal to what? 0. So this becomes minus PE cos theta. So this is our formula of potential energy of dipole at an angle theta, and this theta is the angle between dipole moment P and electric field E, right? You can also write this formula in vector form. AB cos theta means what? A dot B. So PE cos theta is equal to what? Minus P dot E. So this is your formula in vector form. Potential energy of dipole. Now in this topic you have to remember some important points. The first point is, when this theta is equal to 0, means it is like this condition. Electric field is here, negative and positive charge is here. So the dipole moment is from negative to positive. P and E both are in same direction, so angle between P and E is equal to what? 0. So the potential energy of dipole is equal to what? Minus PE cos 0, and the cos 0 is equal to 1. So this is equal to minus PE. So this energy is minimum at angle 0. When the energy is minimum, every system is a most stable condition in this state. Means whenever the energy is 0, the system is in most stable condition. So this is the most stable state of dipole. The second condition, when theta is equal to pi, means electric field is in this direction, negative charge is here, positive charge is here, so dipole moment is from negative to positive. So direction of P and E both are in opposite, so angle is equal to pi. So the potential energy is P minus P cos pi. Cos pi is equal to minus 1, so minus minus becomes plus 1. So this is the maximum energy. So whenever the energy, your potential energy is maximum, the system is in most unstable state. And when the angle between potential energy, electric field and dipole moment is pi by 2, then what happened? The potential energy is what? 0. So 0 is the not minimum, minus PE is the minimum. So this is the most stable state of dipole, when the angle between dipole moment and electric field is what? 0. And this is the most unstable. You have to remember this topic for your short question and MCQs. This is the important theory for your examination.